Welcome. This video contains an introduction, an interview so you can gain deeper understanding of the subject from spirit level, and a group frequency calibration so you can start to clear the frequency distortion patterns around this topic. Enjoy. Hi everyone, my name is Karen Cheong and I'm here with my co-host Dennis Kelly. The spaces we reside in, whether they be our homes, our places of work, or even our cars, hold the frequencies of the things that are in those spaces, whether they are seen or unseen. Now, those frequencies can sometimes cause a leaching of energy, disrupted sleep, emotional unease, or even physical breakdown. So today, we're going to talk about how to clear spaces of frequencies that you don't want, and how to condition spaces with high-level frequencies so that you can feel nourished and can accelerate down your path. So let's dive right in. Dennis?
Space. So, Karen, a lot of things come to me when you bring up the concept of space and, you know, how clean that space is or how cluttered that space is, both physically or energetically. Mm-hmm. I'm not even quite sure where to start, but one of the questions I would have is, let's say that I live somewhere and I've learned something about this home that I live in. Mm-hmm. And I've got the feeling there's something going on. It's kind of spooky. It's I think it's possessed or there's ghost or what do I do with that? Or what are your thoughts?
Okay. So spaces are very influenced by the things that are in it, whether or not they're seen or they're unseen. So there are a number of things that can govern what are in spaces. So just because someone died in a home, it doesn't mean it's haunted. I just like to put that out there.
Okay.
Just because someone died there doesn't mean it's haunted.
Yep.
Okay. Usually, there is a spirit that will cause unrest if it died suddenly or unhappily. That typically means that it will be around. If there was ceremony done there, that it would be around. If like the land that your house is on was a place where ceremony was done, then that can be a place where there are lingering spirits that are protective of that space, right? Because if it's a sacred space for ceremony, then it's a protected space, and you didn't know the house goes up on it, and you're kind of an invader of that space, right? So they're trying to protect their space. Ceremony can also be dark, so that can be there. There can be energetic places on the earth which have, just because of the way ley lines work and other energetic grid lines work on the earth, not just ley lines, other grid lines, you can have spaces where you have a lot of negative energy. It's very difficult for it to be there. So, for example, you know, in every town there seems to be a place where there's like a lot of like homelessness or drug addiction or whatever, and it's very specific parts of the town, but nowhere else. And yet within like two or three blocks from it, it's fine. So that would be an example of where ley lines or other energetic lines that are crossing cause negativity, like a negative vortex, for example. So that your house could be on a mini one of those or a large one of those, depending what it is. So there's many things that could cause disruptive frequencies to be running in your space. So really, to clear space, so I know there's a lot of like saging and there's like copal and then there's like whatever it is that you can use. So really, the best thing to use to clear space is pure source frequency and Mother Earth. So if you can use that, then what happens is you clear the space. So really, it doesn't really matter what implement is used, like what the thing is to you. Yeah. It's really about the frequency of the person clearing the space. So what's important about this conversation is this conversation. I mean, the conversation itself is helpful in terms of understanding, but really what it's about is the GFC following this. Because if you listen to it, you're going to find that it will be about clearing space. And I'll probably do a more extended one if you have like a more tenacious situation that will go up on my website. But for now, for most people, even if, for example, there are some people where in the space there's this frequency of like a disruptive sleep frequency, because what happens is things, for whatever reason, the space opens up and in dream time their sleep gets disrupted. So if you clear all frequencies, if you clear the space of all frequencies except for pure source, it's like a blank canvas. And then it's a very highly resonating space that is nurturing and nourishing and can help you to move your path forward. So you want that. So really what we would do is just clear the whole thing, bring it to the pure source frequency, and that will clear the space. So really, it doesn't matter, to go back to my original point, it doesn't matter what instrument you use, it's about the frequency of the person who's doing the clearing. So if you do a GFC, what happens is, because you're linked in with me, and I am of a certain vibrational level, what happens is, in our work together, we can clear the space of any of these frequency patterns and just bring it into alignment with the pure source frequency, which is very high.
Okay.
So, that was a long answer to your question.
So I was real curious. So I live out in Memphis, Tennessee, or I'm in Buffalo, New York, or whatever, and you're wherever you are. And so what you're saying is that you not being there can help me clear this space.
Yeah, because it doesn't matter, because we're working in the timeless. We're working beyond time space. We're amplifying the frequency of pure source, and basically we're like neutralizing all other frequencies. So it doesn't matter where you are physically. Yeah. If you listen to the GFC and tap into this mastermind, which is all about clearing the space, then what will happen is that will happen. It will just clear space. And it's not just about the space like internal to the home, it's also the land. Because oftentimes, like I said, there will be times where you're on something that is sacred to someone else, and that's probably not a good idea for you to be there. And so you need to clear that out as well. So you need to deal with the land in addition to the structure, if that makes sense.
Is one easier or more difficult than the other, versus, you know, house versus land?
Or no, that's the same.
It's energy.
It's all frequencies. Yeah.
So you can work with that, whatever that is.
Yeah.
And so, the other thought was, you know, if I'm having trouble sleeping in this bedroom, or I'm hearing noises, or I just don't feel right. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe my first question might be, is it me or is it the external space?
Yeah, it could be either or both.
Okay.
Okay. And there's a third answer, which is something in the space that you have brought in.
Okay. Oh, okay.
All right. So those were a lot of options there. So it could be that you yourself are possessed. It's possible. So you actually are causing. I have had situations where there have been clients who are possessed by entities, and because they have this possession, it calls in other things to come into their space. And so they have a lot of disruption physically. They have trouble sleeping. They have physical breakdown. So it's, you know, and then what happens is other things come into the space as a result of the possession, right? Because they have now more distorted frequency patterns. They are, if they have a lot of darkness, some people are possessed more than once. They have more than one thing possessing them. It can call in other things to start to be in their space. Okay, so it can be the person calling in that thing. It could be the space itself, right?
Yeah.
Or it could be something that you brought into your space, not knowing that it's actually causing things to come in to have lower, like the frequency of the object.
What would a good example of that might be? If I bring in my grandfather's...
No, it's not even that. It's not like an urn or something like that with like ashes in it. It would be something like a couple of things. Like sometimes people buy objects that were done for ritual or ceremony that are not appropriate to bring into one's home because it was for a sacred purpose, yes?
Yeah. Yeah.
And it has a certain thing with it. And sometimes those ceremonies were dark, and sometimes they were for a specific purpose. Okay, so there's two different things. Sorry, I just muddled things. So one, sometimes ceremonies are dark. If you bring in a dark ceremony object, it has the frequency of the dark ceremony. So you're gonna call in whatever thing they called in the dark ceremony into your space. It may seem cool, but really it's not. The other possibility is you bring in a ceremonial item that was done for sacred ceremony, but it was supposed to be just for that sacred ceremony. It really wasn't meant to be like an objet on your mantelpiece. It was meant for that thing. And so there are beings that can be, you're kind, you know what I mean? You're like, it's not supposed to be for a display. It's supposed to be for ceremony. And so there are things that can come in. It's like a protective element to it. Does that make sense? Because it's not being used appropriately. That thing is not being used appropriately. It can be a crystal, for example, that's brought in that, so the way crystals work is that they hold the programming, six programs, Okay, so crystal, just like our computers or whatever, are can hold programming. They hold memory, they hold programming. Water is crystalline, that's why water has memory. So so if you bring in a crystal, crystals are very, very sensitive. They can hold six programs, and they'll just amplify those six programs forever. Amplify, amplify, which is really cool, because if you're the one who puts your intention into the crystal, it can broadcast that program, which is really awesome. However, if you receive a crystal, if you receive a crystal that has been programmed for maybe not so awesome things, it can cause disruption. It can cause, dead people to come towards you. It can, you know, because you don't know who held that crystal and programmed it. It may have picked up a program from something in the field. If a crystal's empty, it's open, basically, to programming. Right? So it can pick up all kinds of stuff. So if you bring a crystal in and you don't know what it is and you haven't cleared it, then it's very possible that what you've brought into your space is not clear and is emanating or amplifying this frequency of whatever, not goodness, you know, like unrest, misery, non-abundance, scarcity, dead people, whatever it is it's doing, and it's in your space. So that could be another possibility, that you've brought an object into your space that's causing that. So that was like three possibilities.
So where would you suggest that I start? If I'm experiencing these, you know, where do I start?
Yeah. I mean, so what I would start is with the GFC, because it's free at the end of this video. If it doesn't clear, then there's two things. One is I'm probably going to do a more extensive GFC online, right? So if you have a situation that's more a little bit more complex or more deep that doesn't seem to be resolving, then the third possibility is to have a private session with me, because then I can scan you and see if you are possessed or if it's something other than your space. And I likely will offer another GFC where it's clearing of things. So you can bring your precious sacreds, your crystals or your whatever, and we can clear those. But I have not. That doesn't exist yet, but eventually it will. So you might want to clear all your, you want all of your crystals and everything that you wear, like things around your neck or whatever, like on your hands, you want them to be clear because they're in your field and you don't know what's in them. So it's better just to clear them all and then be done. And then you know that at least you're the one who's controlling what they're emanating, as opposed to you don't know what they are. You just think they're pretty or whatever, and you're wearing them.
So just going back, your first response was just, you know, use the GFC that's attached to this segment.
Yeah.
And so when you say use it,
listen to it.
Just I myself listen, or let it play during the day, or how do I use it?
Oh, okay, I see. So I would listen to it actively at least once or twice.
I myself, maybe headset and just listen to it.
Yep. Okay. And then you can play it on the background in very low volume. Okay. Just around, and it will, because it's amplifying its own frequency into the field. So, yes.
So we're back to that frequency. So
yeah, it's always frequencies.
And so because of the GFC and the frequency it's at and the frequency of the room, and so...
It'll just clear. And so because Pure Source is the highest frequency possible, it dominates. And it sounds like a negative term, but it has the most authority. Yeah. Let's put it that way. Yeah. It has the most authority. It is the highest authority. So it will then clear everything else.
Yeah.
So that's why you want to do the GFC, the free one. If that doesn't seem to work, try the other one on my website. If not, private session. Because it's hard to tell as an individual, is it me, the space, or an object I've brought in? It's hard to tell.
Yeah. You know, I see a lot of folks, you know, wearing the rings and the necklaces. Yeah. And I hear you say, well, you know, just clear it. Just get cleared. And so you don't know where it came from. You don't. And, you know, I hear a lot of people, well, this is my great-grandmother's. And, you know, so... Yeah. What is the clearing of these?
Yeah.
What does that look
so
like?
So what that looks like is that, I would lead a GFC, which I haven't done yet, but I will, where we clear, which means essentially if you amplify, the best and only way to clear things effectively is to amplify Mother Earth, the Earth frequency, because we're all of it. Right? The crystals, it doesn't matter what it is. The crystal, the mother's piece of jewelry, whatever. Yeah. It's all from the Earth. So if you hold it and we can amplify the earth energy right through it, it clears it. It just like brings it back to like a neutral space, because it's just earth energy. That's it. Dominates again, because just like with Pure Source, if it's from the earth, the set point is the earth. So if you clear it with that frequency, it clears it up.
So life goes on, and I wear this necklace and I go out and about and I'm at the cocktail party and da 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 da. So, you know, a lot of things are happening. Is this something, do I have to constantly keep clearing?
Oh, no, no, no. Once you clear it once, you're good.
Once you clear,
you're
done. It's clear.
Yeah, with an object, yes.
With an object.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And once you clear a house, generally speaking, yes, and the land, generally speaking, yes, unless it's a situation where it's just you happen to be in a place, in a confluence of where these grid lines run into each other. And sometimes you are, and then in that case, you really, I mean, the best in that scenario, which is very rare but happens, the best is actually to move, because you can't reverse that. It's the grid lines of the earth. So
do you sometimes actually get down to that point where the laws of nature and the grid lines, mm-hmm, and all that is just so powerful that it's better just to face the music and move?
Yeah, I have not come to that situation, but I know that it exists.
Okay.
Yeah, I know that it exists.
Okay. So, I assume all these pertain to the office setting too?
Yeah, so it doesn't really matter whether you're in your home or your office space or your car. It's any place that you reside in, like that you spend a lot of time in. So your office space could be similar. It's a little bit more challenging with office spaces because there are other people in it in addition to you.
Yeah.
But we can clear the space and you enough that it can keep the field clear. But it's more of a challenge because you have more people. You have a little bit less control over it.
Yeah.
So, but yes, you can clear your office space as well. Yes.
Is there something I can do as an individual? Let's say I'm invited to a gathering, mm-hmm, at a new restaurant or, mm-hmm, a new museum or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And as soon as I walk in that door, it's just like, oh, I just have this feeling. It's just this heavy kind of...
Yeah.
Is there something I can do?
Yes.
When I move into a space,
mm-hmm,
and I can feel that blanket of almost darkness or...
Yeah. So you just connect to pure source.
So I connect to pure source. So how do I do that?
Well, if you don't know what you're doing, it's going to be a little bit tough. If you've done a GFC, then, or you've had a session with me and you're advanced enough, you can do it with your intention.
Yep.
I would say you can do it just with your intention. It's easier if you've worked with somebody who has a very strong connection, because it will be clearer and faster for you. Yep. These GFCs are free at the ends of these videos, so you can just do that, and eventually you'll be able to just hold on your own. Yep. But so it's with your intention, essentially. Yeah. And it may be that if you're a total newbie and you've never done this before, it's a little harder to establish because you haven't established enough clearing on your own to be able to do it.
Yeah.
But as you get stronger, all you do is connect, and then that's it.
So as you do this work and as you evolve in the frequency, vibration, the higher level,
mm-hmm,
you can move into these spaces where before you might have had, challenges.
Yeah.
You can move into them.
Yeah.
And you're okay.
Yeah, because it's all about strength.
Yeah.
So the more you ascend, the more you can hold your center and neutrality, your power, your completeness, without being affected by an external source.
Yeah.
So it's about, can you hold that irrespective of what's happening around you? It's a strengthening, actually. So you could, sometimes it's a test to see if you can hold it.
Yeah.
And so it can be a strengthening, like I said, a strengthening thing. But yes, it gets to a point where you can without it. And it's not that you don't notice it. And the other thing I'm going to say is, so it's not that you don't notice it, so you do. And if you are under attack, which happens sometimes, then it's not about just like, this is kind of, it's funny, people are like, it's okay, I'm neutral. I'm like, no, defend yourself. If you're being attacked, then defend yourself. that is appropriate.
Yeah.
Okay, so just like, get off.
Yeah.
Like, you can fling it away from you or whatever it is.
Yeah, this whole space thing, the space within and the space around, is quite a challenge for some people.
Yeah, it can be.
So.
Yeah.
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 So, well, Karen, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Karen, could you help me? I hear so often when I look at your video or your website, GFC. Exactly, what is that?
A GFC is a group frequency calibration, which looks a lot like a guided meditation on a particular topic. And what I'm doing is I'm helping you to remove the distortion patterns of that particular topic. And because you're coming together as a mastermind in a group to connect to pure source even more. And to clear the distortion patterns of this particular topic, what happens is a tremendous amount of momentum starts to happen because of the energetic of the entire group. And each individual is able to move faster and ascend higher than they could have on their own.
Welcome, everyone. This is the group frequency calibration on clearing space. All right. So let's begin by having you bring your attention between your heart and your throat space. And as you bring your attention to this part of your body, we're going to take three breaths together. So on your first breath, inhale and hold your breath for at least 4 seconds before exhaling all the air out of your lungs and holding your exhaled breath out also for 4 seconds. And in your next breath, whenever you arrive here, you don't have to go on the timing that my voice is indicating. Inhale and hold your breath for at least a second longer than you did the previous breath. And when you get to your exhale, hold your breath out for at least a second longer than you did your previous breath. And notice if it's easier for you to hold a full breath or an empty breath. And then whenever you arrive at your third breath, inhaling and holding your breath in for as long as you think you can. And when you get to that edge of discomfort where you feel like you cannot hold it any longer, you're going to exert your will and hold it for at least a second longer. And notice if you allow yourself to really reach that edge or if you cut out a little early. Without judgment, just notice what you choose. And on the exhale, you're going to similarly exhale all the air out of your lungs and hold your exhaled breath or your voided breath out for as long as you think you can. And again, when you feel like you can't hold it out any longer, you're going to exert your will and hold your breath out for at least a second longer. Now, this is particularly important for this GFC because we are asserting your dominion over your space. So if you can't govern yourself, it's hard to govern your space. And whenever you're complete with your three breaths, you're going to bring your attention, awareness, focus to the space between your belly button and the base of your sternum. And your sternum is that big, thick bone in the center of your chest where your ribs meet in front of your body. Good. And for those of you who are new, I'm waiting for the mastermind to gel. So I'm going to take this opportunity to let you know that I work on you at the group and the subgroup level, and that I will be making noises on my end. So you likely will hear me exhale sharply or hum or yawn, even though I'm not tired. And that's how I remove the distortion patterns at this time and move the frequencies around. I also am working more and more in silence. So if you don't hear anything from my end, I'm still working on you. Okay. Yeah, there is the mastermind. It's just gelled. So now, we're going to ask ourselves the following question to ourselves. And that question is, how can I become even more aware of my connection only to pure source? And that question again is, how can I become even more aware of my connection only to pure source? And as you ask yourself that question, please imagine, sense, feel, or become aware of a brilliance deep, deep inside of your body that starts to become even brighter. That starts to expand even more. And become even more radiant as you become even more aware of your connection only to pure source. And for those of you who would like to expand beyond your body and the room that you're in, into the stars, or even further, that is fine as long as you keep some part of your attention on or in some part of your body. This is very important. Good. And as a note, I am working at source level to expand your natural bandwidth or connection, irrespective of what level you think you're at. So now becoming aware of the space between your lower ribs and your throat. So before you can clear a space, you need to be clear to some degree of certain distortions, and then we will clear the space through you. Okay, so we'll work together to clear the space. The higher you vibrate, and especially with my help, you will be able to clear the space more effectively. Okay? So before we get to the space, actually, what we're going to do is this. You're going to imagine the space you want to clear, be it your home, or a place you're about to visit, or your office, or your car, wherever it is. Perhaps a friend or a lover's or a parent's home that you visit often. Whatever the space is, you're going to imagine standing in the very center of it, okay? And once you imagine yourself standing in the center of this space, you're going to bring your attention from your lower ribs all the way up to your throat. Oh. So the first distortion pattern that we're going to clear is that you need an implement or something else to help you clear space. You don't need anything. You just need your connection to pure source, a certain level of frequency, essentially. And then harnessing the power of the earth or the frequency of the earth to clear. All right? So that certain level of frequency is what I'm helping you with. And for some of you, a small group of you, at some point you won't need my help. You'll just be able to do it, which is great. We don't want to create dependence on me. We want you guys to become empowered. Okay? So, focusing between your lower ribs all the way to your throat. So essentially, this belief that you need to rely on something like an implement or a substance is a distortion of your own trust in yourself, okay, and your connection. So just removing this additional nuance. So now, you're going to imagine, once again, yourself standing in the middle of this space. And as you become more and more aware of your connection to pure source, and I'll help you, you're going to become aware of a tube running through the midline of your body. And this tube is going to start to glow or glow with a color that you really like or hum with a vibration or a sound that you really like. You might feel the hum instead of hearing it with your ears. Either is valid. Okay. Or it's just going to seem to grow brighter. So as we work together, you're going to imagine this tube running through the very center of your body. Here we go. Is glowing brighter, humming more loudly, or becoming more intense in its color. However it appears to you is perfectly wonderful. And as we work together, the humming or color or brightness or feeling becomes so intense, it starts to emanate from the center of you, clearing through the space all around you, pushing further and further out through the space, filling it. Even further until you reach the outer edges of the structure. And then it's going to simultaneously, for some of you, and for others, one after the other, drop down into the earth and then up into the sky. And now, that color, tone, or feeling is going to come back towards you and into your center. Leaving the space that it just filled, neutral, empty, clear. So now the tube is back focused within your body. And now what you're going to do is become aware of the frequency, vibration, or energy of the center of the earth. And that is going to come through the center of the earth, up into the soles of your feet and up into the tube. And as it rushes into the tube, intensifying as it rushes in, it becomes so either intense or full, it spills out of you, washing out through you and through the space that you wish to clear, like water washing out from the center of you, out through you and through the space that you wish to clear, clearing away any heaviness or anything that no longer serves. And now that frequency comes washing back towards you, having dumped somewhere along the way that low density, the static, or anything else that was in that space, or anything dark. Very good. Good. You're going to take a deep breath in, hold it for 1 to 2 seconds, and then release it with some sound. Very good. Bringing your attention and focus awareness to your heart space. Clearing out any residual stickiness or heaviness that may have collected here. Especially if there are people that are in the space with you that are heavy. Okay, so clearing this out from you. If you happen to have picked it up, some of you have not, so you don't need this, but some of you have, so clearing this out. Very good. And so now, bring your attention back to that space that you were clearing, and notice that it feels like nothing, neutral, clear. And notice if you can rest here in this clarity of nothingness. Good.
This brings us to the end of this session. I look forward to working with you on the next GFC. These GFCs help people release distortion patterns. It's my sincere hope that you benefit profoundly from this series, which is why I spend so much of my personal resources creating these as my gift to the world. If a GFC topic resonates with you, often more work that can be provided in this one GFC is needed to really clear or loosen deeply held distortion patterns in areas that are sticky. Because these patterns are like layers of an onion, usually there are multiple layers to individual topics. Depending on how much of a challenge this topic is for you, it may make sense for you to go deeper than what this session allows. If you feel this is the case for you, please visit sphericalluminosity.com for more targeted support.